the Asia-Pacific region for smart cars is a huge opportunity. It currently represents 40% of the total world market, but it's the fastest growing area in the world, with a growth of about 30% per annum in terms of smart cars usage. There are countries like Japan, Taiwan, Hong Kong, Singapore, Australia, New Zealand, which would say are very well advanced, very well developed in terms of smart cars. So there's still development opportunities there, but they are well on the way to developing there. China, and obviously with the size of China, there are huge opportunities there. Philippines, Malaysia, Indonesia, Thailand and Vietnam. And these, if you like, are the second level, if you like, where there are huge growth opportunities because they haven't started along the track at the moment. And obviously China, just the sheer size of China offers opportunities there. And all of these countries are obviously looking at smart card technologies in all the different deployments. Let's say the slightly less wealthy countries like Myanmar, Laos and Cambodia, which were coming in there, they are going to be opportunities, but they will be slightly lower because obviously implementing smart card strategies cost a lot of money. Applications interest them. That's obviously a huge market. But it tends, in terms of the classical SIM card, tends to be a fairly low-value commodity item. But telecoms are going to be developed, and the mobile telephone is likely to be the base for a multi-application smart card. So in the future, your telephone is probably also going to be able to be your form of payment, your access control, everything else as well. So there's very much great interest in telecoms. What is also is of interest for companies is EMV, which is called European Mastercard Visa, which is a system which is being introduced into different countries, and it is basically a way of securizing payment, so to reduce fraud. The traditional bank card with the magnetic stripe actually is much more open to fraud than the kind of EMV system. So the EMV system is well introduced throughout Europe. It's now being introduced in different countries throughout Asia, and North America is following afterwards. But it's fairly expensive to put in place, but it does reduce massively the amount of fraud that can be done with payment systems. Also, micropayment is interesting for opportunities. And also the link between payment cards and loyalty cards. If we're talking about CRM, is how you link a bank card into loyalty systems and being able to give rewards to consumers. In terms of loyalty cards, currently 50% of at least 50% of all Asian shop brands have their own loyalty card. Sometimes these are sole cards, sometimes they're actually multi-brand cards, well, co-branded cards that are linked up to banks. And growth forecast at the moment is for 34% per year in terms of loyalty cards, growing. Particularly in terms of payments, one of the technologies that is increasingly coming and being developed is contactless, so that you don't have to put a smart card in a machine, but to wave it atop, a bit like the Octopus card in Hong Kong. And this technology is being used more and more in as many applications as possible because it makes its ease of use is increased. The other thing, it also brings huge increases in productivity. If you think of about a retailer, let's take a fast food outlet, and if you're getting payment of someone using a contactless card, you imagine the time you save. You've got a lot of people coming into your fast food outlets, and the payment is you do it with a swipe of your card rather than putting in a machine and actually tapping out a number or signing, etc. Can think about the amount of productivity that's increased by that. So there is a lot of investment going into contactless technologies. I would say the major application that interests the government is in terms of the security, in producing passports, identity cards based on biometrics. So they're much more secure and much more difficult to kind of replicate in a fraud system. So it's an anti-fraud system for passports and identity cards, and that is something where Hong Kong, with their Smartix system, are way ahead in terms of producing these types of immigration cards, identity cards, driving license. But this is something that is happening all over the world, where governments are looking to try and make their border controls more secure. One of the major problems, or one of the major fears for government in terms of security at the moment, is cybercrime in its very largest sense. a lot of smart card technology is to do with digital security, making identification more securing, access control, etc. And this is something that they should be encouraging, because cybercrime could be a major problem. And cybercrime is, in terms of governments, becomes an even bigger problem, in the sense that when you normally have crime, it tends to be national. The local policemen can deal with that within their own national territories. As soon as you get into cybercrime, it might be that a bank account in Hong Kong has money taken out of it, but the person who's taking that out of it might be in a totally different country. So the question is, where does the crime take place? Who has responsibility for it? And how do you then deal with that? And that means dealing between different governments, different police forces, etc. So anything that can help digital security, which a lot of smart cards applications are doing about, is obviously going to be a huge benefit to governments in terms of their security side.